day to all. So this is we are going to see problem number 3, a beam of simply supported beam, so carrying at the UDL load throughout the beam. Okay, first let us draw this beam. Okay, so this is your beam A section. This is point A, some simply supported fixed, and B is simply supported. So throughout the beam, UDL load is acting on the beam. So W, small W per unit length. The total length of the beam is L. Okay, W and the length of the beam will be L. Okay, so the first solution, the first initially we have to assume a trial solution. So let us take a trigonometrical function solution, y equal to a1 sin of phi x by L plus a2 sin of 3 phi x by L. Okay, so that will be equation number 1. Okay, so now we know that the potential energy is equal to U minus H. U is your strain energy, H is your work done by the external force. Okay, so we know that the U formula is EI by 2 integral 0 to L d square y by dx square whole square into dx. So this you have to memorize this equation to solve this problem. Okay, so we know that the trial solution is Y, right? So from this y we have to derive d square y by dx square, that is we have to differentiate this y with respect to x. Okay, so dy by dx is equal to a1 into, if you differentiate this sign, it will become cos of y x by l into pi by l plus a2 into cos of 3 pi x by l into 3 pi by l. Okay, so this is basic differentiation. Again one more time we have to differentiate, so we need to find d square y by dx square. Okay, so a1, if you differentiate cos, it will become minus sin pi x by l, right? So minus, and already the pi by l is there, so pi square by l square will be there, plus minus, similarly a2 sin of 3 pi x by l into 9 pi square by l square, right? Already there is 3 pi by l is there. Okay, so now we have to substitute this d square y by dx square into this equation. We will get u equal to a by 2 integral 0 to l. So the whole term has to be substituted in strain energy formula. Okay, so I have written this. Okay, so the next step is we have to take the negative side outside. Since it is being a whole square, if you take the negative side outside, it will become positive, right? So a by 2. So the remaining term will be, so plus a1 pi square by l square pi x by l plus a2 sin of 3 9 pi square by l square into sin of 3 pi x by l square whole square into dx, right? So this term pi square by l square can be taken out, right? Ei, that pi square has to be squared, right? Pi power 4 by 2 l power 4. The remaining term a1 sin of phi x by l plus a2 sin of 3 phi x by l, okay, whole square into dx. Okay, now this term is like a plus b whole square. We have to expand a square plus b square plus 2ab. Okay, so let us expand. Okay, u equal to a pi power 4 by 2 l power 4 integral 0 to l. So a1 square into, this is your first term, plus this is your second term b square, 81 a2 square, and the third term 9 a1 a2 9 into 2 18 a1 a2 on the remaining term. Okay, this we can split it into three parts, right? A square will be one term, b square will be one term, and c, a 2ab will be one term, right? A pi power 4, the remaining term of, we can directly take in as, so this is one term and this is second term and this is your third term, right? So each are different terms. So first let us write it, first a1 square sin square pi x by l into dx, that will be one term. Again integral 0 to l 81 a2 square sin square 3 pi x by l, that is the second term, and similarly your third term 18 a1 a2 sin phi x by l. So please remember this equation. So we are going to take the first term alone, then integrate it and find the solution, okay, and substitute all the values in the above equation. Okay, so let us take the first term, 0 to l a1 square sin square of phi x by l into dx is equal to, so a1 square we can take it outside, and the remaining term sin square theta is equal to 1 minus cos 2 theta divided by 2. Okay, so we have written sin square theta is equal to 1 minus cos 2 theta divided by 2. So in that form we can write it down, 1 minus cos 2 pi x by l by 2. The same can be again split into two term integral, the 2 can be taken outside, and dx minus cos 2 pi x by l will be each and separate term, okay, split into two terms. Okay, so now again if you integrate this dx, it will become x, and if you integrate this cos, it will become sin 2 pi x by l by 2 pi by l. So you know the formula of integration of cos theta, cos theta, cos 2 theta sin 2 theta by 2, right? Again, so a1 square l by 2 will be there, this whole term becomes 0, because you know that sin 2 pi x by l will be become sin 2 pi after cancelling these two terms, sin 2 pi will be 0, right? So if you wanted to understand, you have to understand the sine curve first. Okay, so let us draw the sine curve. So starting from 0, pi by 2 pi, and 3 pi by 2, and it will 2 pi, and it is 3 pi and 4 pi. Okay, so sine 0, pi, 2 pi, 3 pi, 4 pi will be 0, right? Sine pi by 2 will be plus 1, and sine 3 pi by 2 will be minus 1. Okay, this you have to remember, this graph. Okay, so now we are taking the second term, 81 a2 square sin square of 3 pi x by l. Okay, again by similarly we can split this into 1 minus cos 2 theta divided by 2, right? So 1 minus cos of 6 pi x by l by 2, the 2 can be taken outside. Okay, again split it into two parts. If you integrate the integral dx, it will become x, and the remaining term will be written like this, right? So you know already the formula. Okay, it will become 81 a2 square l by 2. The remaining term will be 0, because sin 6 pi is also 0. Okay, now we have to take it the third term, that is 18 a1 a2 sin of phi x by l into sin of 3 pi x by l. This can be re-altered, that is let me take it 18 a1 a2 constant outside and sin 3 pi x by l into sin of phi x by l. So this term is looks like sin a into sin b, so this can be written as cos of a minus b minus cos of a plus b divided by 2. Okay, so again we have to apply the same formula, 18 a1 a2, so integral 0 to l, so 1 by 2 into cos of, if you reduce it, it will become 2 pi x by l, and if you reduce a plus b, it will become cos 4 pi x by l. Okay, again split it into two parts, cos of 2 pi x by l minus cos of 4 pi x by l, so it is being split into two parts, right? So again if you integrate this cos 2 pi x by l, it will become sin of 2 pi x by l divided by 2 pi by l, and integrating cos of 4 pi x by l will become sin of 4 pi x by l divided by 4 pi by l. So now this whole term will become 0, right? Because if you apply sin 4 pi 0, sin 6 pi also 0, sin 2 pi and sin 4 pi will be 0, so that the whole term is 0. Now we have to substitute all these values into this equation, right? Term 1 and term 2 and term 3, we found out the values, right? So e equal to a pi power 4 divided by 2 into L power 4, and we have to substitute the first term value and second term value and the third term value. Okay. So now if you simplify this, we can take L outside and 2 outside. So the remaining term will be A1 square plus A1 A2 square. If you reduce this, it will become A pi power 4 divided by 4 L cube into A1 square plus A2 A1 A2 square. So this will be the value of U, that is your strain energy. Okay, so next we should develop the equation for work done by external forces. So that is simply supported with UDL load. H is equal to integral 0 to L small w y into dx. Okay, so for that we have to solve this. Okay, we know that y equal to a1 sine of phi x by L plus a2 sine of 3 pi x by L into dx. Okay, so we have substituted y value in this equation. Now we can split this equation into two terms. Okay, integral 0 to L sine of phi x by L and sine of 3 pi x by L. Okay, now okay, we have to integrate this sine theta, then cos theta by cos 2 theta by theta, okay, 0 to L, plus again cos of 3 pi x by L divided by 3 pi by L, 0 to L limit applied. Okay. Okay, so if you apply the limit, so divided by pi by L can be taken into L by pi, and cos the remaining time cos pi x by L, that we have to apply a lower limit and upper limit, and the similarly the cos 3 pi x by L by also there, right? So now if you apply cos pi x by L, it will become minus 1. If you apply 0, then cos 0 is equal to 1. Similarly, cos 3 pi minus 1, cos 0, 1. Okay. So, refer these formulas. Now, so if you simplify this, so it will become 2a1 L by pi plus 2a2 L by 3 pi. So, if you take it outside 2 L by pi, then it will become a1 plus a2 by 3. So this will be your total work done by the external forces of UDL load. Okay. So now we know the total potential energy formula, pi equal to U minus H. Substitute the U value and H value in this equation. Okay. This is your U value already derived, and this is your H value. So that is derived. So let us say this is equation number 3. So to minimize this equation, we have to apply a condition of dou pi by dou a1 is equal to 0, and a1 square will be 2a1, right? And the a2 term neglected. Similarly, there will be only 1 in the next term. So if you simplify this equation becomes a1 becomes 4w L power 4 divided by a power 5. Okay, so this is your value of a1. Now we have to find out A2 value. So dou pi by dou A2 is equal to 0, A pi power 4, 4 L cube and 162 A2. So here there will be only one term, 1 by 3. Okay. So again you can simplify this term. So A2 value become 4 W L power 4 divided by 243 EI pi power 5. This will be your A2 term. Okay. Okay, so we already know that y value equal to a1 sine of phi x by L plus a2 sin of 3 pi x by l. By applying the boundary condition x equal to l by 2, y becomes y max, and y max is equal to a1 minus a2. Okay, so y max value we have to find out. So a1 value we already know that 4 wl power 4 by e pi power 4. So similarly a2 value, substitute to this, and the common terms can be taken outside, 4 wl power 4 e pi power 4 1 minus 1 by 243. Okay, so if you reduce this 1 minus 1 by 243, the remaining term will be 0.9958, right? Okay, so this can be approximately written as 4 wl power 4 a pi power 5. So this is the final value of maximum deflection, right? Okay, okay, so this is the result. Thank you, friends. If you like it, please share and comment. Thank you very much.